arrested last year, and reports that two kindergarten pupils had died of suspected pneumonia at the time after being exposed to too much cold while studying under a tree. So a year after that report, well, he's been finding out whether anything has changed.
Okay, number three. How many triangles are here? Yes, Kadri. Count.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Very good. How many are there?
6.
Good. Who can come and ride a 6?
Here at the Azudoone Primary School at Sirigo in the Kasina Nankana West District of the Upper East Region, this combined class of KG and Primary 1 and 2 pupils are having lessons for the first time this week. Their lessons on Monday were disrupted by rain because their classroom is under the sunshade of this thorny tree on their school compound. Their teacher, Laurentia Asar, has a difficult task teaching three combined classes of infant minds under this tree.
It's very difficult for us to teach under a tree like this. And then being one teacher, controlling three classes, is very difficult. And then, more to the point, under a tree, whenever it rains during this rainy season, it's very hard. So it even affects our academics. Teaching and learning is always very hard. It's very difficult for the children to understand whatever that we are doing. And even being outside like this, as you can see, this is the road. People may be passing, and then people may be doing some things, and then the children will not, they will lose concentration of what we are doing. So they will be looking elsewhere.
There are about 30 children in this class, and a brilliant 8-year-old Alice Ayangba sits among them with big dreams for the future.
This is my school. We are suffering. Government, help us.
Away from this classroom under the tree is a mud structure that serves as a classroom block for classes 3 to 5. A recent rainstorm ripped off the roof of one of the classrooms, which has created this congestion in the school.
This view is not very good for us. The class is not very big for us. So we don't feel comfortable in this class. So we want the government to come and build it for us.
Our school is not good for us. The classroom is small for us. We want government to come and build a nice structure for us.
Even in this shelter, lessons often come to an abrupt end when the clouds begin to gather. School authorities fear the building could collapse if there is a storm.
If it's rainy season, we forced to go home because we don't know the school will fall. It is a bad building, so we have to go home. It is not good for us.
Not much has changed since I visited this school more than a year ago, but there is something striking here. World Vision has built 2 toilets and installed a water facility. I asked the headmaster of the Azudoone Primary School, Dominic Akubase, if the toilet is the most critical need of the school.
The last time you came here, up to now, we have not seen any different thing yet. Except that this NGO, World Vision, that came to our aid, they gave us this toilet. That's all about it.
So, didn't you tell them that you needed the classrooms more than the toilets?
Yeah, we told them, but they said they are after sanitation. They are on to toilets. They are not putting up classrooms. And that if you want, we can let this assembly do that for us.
One of the compartments within this toilet facility has not been put to use and rather has been converted into a storeroom for keeping teaching and learning materials because there is no office for the headmaster and his staff.
because of the rainy season, we can't keep our books outside. And at the houses around that, we use one of the rooms as our store. It's far. So we decided to keep it in one of the toilets.
Schools in rural areas like this have critical infrastructural issues which require deliberate investment to solve. For Joy News, Albert Sori, reporting from Senegal.
Call the number four for us. Mm-hmm. It says who can number four water. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Call it.
One. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.